Hey, I'm Dara Whelan, and I'm completing a PhD under Professor Brian Caulfield in the Insight Centre for Data Analytics in UCD. And the title of my talk is Predicting the Future with Technology Without a DeLorean or a Flux Capacitor. So I'm going to start by bringing this all into the future. January 2015, and we're 2 weeks away from Ireland's first Six Nations rugby match against Italy. Rob Kearney is playing for Leinster against Cardiff in the RDS. Takes the ball into his hands, sees a gap between two defenders, and bursts right through it. He's sprinting towards the try line, but there's nobody near him when suddenly, bang! All he can feel down the back of his leg is a sharp, searing pain. It rolls him forward, he knocks the ball on, spilling it. The medical team rush straight over to him. They take one look at him. They know exactly what's gone wrong. More importantly, Rob knows exactly what's gone wrong. He's completely torn his hamstring, and while his colleagues and teammates are winning another Six Nations Championship for Ireland, Rob, well, he's going to have to watch from the sidelines. He's going to have to undergo months of rehabilitation involving stretching and strengthening, and he won't touch ball in competitive action for the rest of the season. All because of preventable injury I see much too often in my physiotherapy clinic. So what could Rob have done in order to prevent this from happening? Well, you got to start out by looking for a crazy professor who's able to travel through time in his DeLorean motor car. You could have got this professor to bring him to the pass, Rob. Could have gone to him and said, Rob, don't play in this match. Don't take that ball on. That would have disastrous consequences for our space-time continuum. And I'm pretty sure it's impossible, or at least we're not working on it in UCD. Instead, I use much simpler technologies to predict the future. I use body-worn inertial sensors, and I use the Microsoft Kinect, both of which are much smaller and cheaper than DeLoreans and flux capacitors. And what I do is I get athletes to perform commonly used movements within their sport and within their training programs. And I analyze these movements using these sensors. The data from these sensors allow me to break down these movements in great detail. And by doing so, I'm able to highlight any inefficiencies that exist within the movements. Once these inefficiencies are highlighted, steps can be put in place to prevent them from occurring and thereby preventing the injury in the future. So Rob does do this. And because of that, he doesn't injure his hamstring in that cold night in January in the RDS. And because of that, he's able to play against Italy in the Six Nations, which, as you're about to see, he's very happy about. There. But this isn't just technology for Rob Kearney, or indeed technology for professional athletes. It's for the recreational runner, whose running style may lead to development of arthritis in the future. It's for Sunday League or amateur footballers, who may go over in their ankle due to poor landing control and miss out on work or sport. It's for children who give up on sport much too early because of preventable injuries. And it's for the older adult who wants to stay fit and healthy into later life, wants to ensure they're doing so safely. My research aims to use low-cost sensor technology to analyse movement within all of these populations, and by doing so, highlight any inefficiencies that exist, thereby reducing the likelihood of them occurring, creating injury. As a physiotherapist and as a sports scientist, I'm passionate about making sure people stay fitter and healthier for longer. One of the major reasons this doesn't happen is because of injury. Wouldn't it be great if we were able to predict the future risk of injury, and by doing so, stop it occurring at all? We could wait for our future self to turn up in the DeLorean and tell us about it. Until then, we'll have to make do with me and these sensors. Thank you.